come to the notice of the law department that various departments of the secretariat, after they are served with the copies of writ petitions, sanction their defense at public expense without offering their comments as to the contentions made in the writ petitions and obtaining legal advice from the solicitor to Government West Pakistan Post Office. In such cases, the solicitor issues necessary authority to the Advocate General or the Advocate General, as the case may be, to appear and defend the writ petitions. First off, this is a very wrong procedure, as it sometimes entails avoidable and necessary expense on the part of the government. First off, when the Advocate General, additional Advocate General, holds in his appearance in a case, he becomes entitled to daily fees. First off, cases are not uncommon in which, although the administrative departments desired that certain writ petitions should be defended at public expense, the law department advised against it on the ground that the writ petitions were not likely to succeed and that it would be sheer waste of money to make any attempt to defend them. First off, all administrative secretaries and heads of attached departments are advised that before they accord sanction to the defense of a writ petition in future, they must supply to the solicitor para-wise comments on the writ petitions and offer their opinion concisely whether and on what grounds they would like the writ petition to be defended at public expense. First up, after the facts are known from the administrative department concerned, the solicitor's department will be in a position to advise whether it would be worthwhile and prudent to defend the writ petition in question or not. First off, this department has already requested all departments of the secretariat to create special desks in their offices and put a reasonable officer in charge of all litigation work of that department, who could supply the necessary details to the solicitor's department. First off,